Hello and welcome. This is Mudassir Afraz from civiltechnologyforyou.com, and today in this session we will learn about how to draw arc in AutoCAD. To draw arc in AutoCAD, you can use this command as A, then you will hit enter, then arc command will be activated. But here you can see arc specifies start point of arc or center. These are two only options, but you can draw in different ways. For that, you will go into the draw panel, and here is the option for arc. You will click on this drop down arrow, and here you can see some more options: 3 points, start, center, end. And let's see one by one how we can just use these options. First, I will click on 3 points. Simply, you will give 3 points, the arc will be drawn. First point, then I will give second point, then I will give third point. This is what 3 point arc. Okay, so I will just enter here Control plus Z to undo this one. Again, I will go into the arc. I will just use this option: start, center, and then end. Okay, so I will click on this one. I will just give a start point as this one, then center point as this one, and end point as this one. So this is what start, center, end. Again, I will press Control plus Z, and then again I will go into the arc. I will use this option: start, center, and angle. You can give angle as well. So I will just click on this. I will give start point, center point, and then I will give angle as well. Okay, so I will just give here the angle of 180 degree, for example, and I will hit enter. Now you can check angle as well. For that, you will go into the annotation panel, and from here I will go in this option. You can see one option here, angular. So I will click on this one, and I will click anywhere on the arc. It will give you the angle of the arc. Okay, now we will use next option. So I will delete this one, and I will directly go into the arc. And now that, what is that? That is start, center, and then we can give length as well. So I will click on this one, and then I will just give start point, then center point, and now I can give length as well. Okay, I can give this point as well as length. So length between these two lines is 30, so I will give 30 unit of length. So I will hit enter. Now this is what start, center, and length. Okay, and then again I will press Control plus Z. Okay, now again I will go into the arc option, and here you can see the option as start, end, and then angle. So I can give angle as well: start point, then end point, then I can give angle. Okay, so for example, I want to give the angle of 90 degree, so I will give 90. Now you can see this is the 90 degree arc. You can check from here. I will go here in this option, and I will check this one, angular, and I will just check this one, 90 degree. Now again I will press Control plus Z. Okay, now again I will go into the arc. Now we will see another option, that is start and end direction. You can give direction as well. So I will give start point, end point. Now I can give direction outward or inward. Okay, now I want to give here. This is the direction option. Okay, again I will press Control plus Z. Again I will go into the arc option. Now let's see what is the next. This is what start, and we can give radius as well. So I will click on this one, start, end, and what is the radius? Okay, the dia here is 30. I can give the radius of 15. Okay, now this is the 15 unit of radius. So again I will press Control plus Z. Again I will go into the arc. Now let's see next option: center, start, and end. So center, then I will press on start, and then this is the end option. Okay, this is what center, start, and end. Again I will press Control plus Z. I will go into the arc option. Let's see next option: center, start, and angle. You can give angle as well here also. Center, then I will press start. Okay, now you can give angle. So let's give an angle of 270 degree. Okay, 270 degree. Now you can see this is 270 degree arc. You can check from here, as I will go here in angular. I can check from here 270. Okay, now again I will press Control plus Z. Now the next option here is center, start, and length. I will click here. I will just give center point, then start point. Now it is asking about what is the length. So length here is 30, so I will give a 30 unit of length. Okay, so 30, then I will press enter. Again I will press Control plus Z. Now let's see the last option, that is continue. Whenever I will click on this one, arc will be continued from where I have stopped the work. So just it is continued from here, and I can just give it the second point anywhere in the screen. Okay, so this is what all about continue. So I hope you understand this session, that how we can draw the arc in different ways. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.